Hey everyone, today I'll be discussing this problem from Codeforces, Tavas and SaDDas. So this is a problem based on bit manipulation or bit masking. So let's understand the problem statement of this question first. So what does the problem says is, let's start it from here. So the problem states that you are given a lucky number n. Okay, so lucky number, they represent it as the number which contain only the digit 4 or 7. So we can have a sequence such as 4, 7, and then we can have 44, then 47, then 74 maybe, then 77, and so on. So these are indexed from 1. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. So what is the input constraints here is? Input constraint here is n, which is up to 10 raised to power 9. So we have given we are given a lucky number n. So let's suppose if the number that was given was 74. So what we have to output is the index of that number. So 74 here has an index of 5. So we have to give this output 5. So let's see how we can approach this problem and how we can use bit masking or bit manipulation in this question to make it a bit simpler. So let's get started with this. Now we can look here. Okay, so this problem has something like this: 4, 7, 44, then 47, 74, and 77. So let's take up an example. Suppose the number given to us, which is n, is equal to 74747. So this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is a 5-digit number. Okay, so what we can do here is how we can approach this is something like, suppose we have 74747. Let's ignore this term, and how many terms are left? These are 4 digits. So how many combinations of 4-digit we can have by using the number 7 and 4? That is, for all the 4 places we have 2 options. We can either put 7 or 4. So what we can say here is we can have 2 raised to power 4. That is 16 combinations. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Now let's see this number 7447. After removing this 7 from here, now let us remove this 4. Okay, so we are left with these 3 digits. So we can have a combination of 2 raised to power 3, which is 8. Then we can remove this. We can have another combination for this, which is 2 raised to power 2, which is 4. And then we can remove 4, and we have just 1 digit left, which will contribute to raised to power 1, which is 2. So let's see this, how this thing is going on. So what we had was 2 raised to power 4 plus 2 raised to power 3 plus 2 raised to power 2 and 2 raised to power 1. So let me rewrite this thing. So we can write it as 2 raised to power 1 plus 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 3 and 2 raised to power 4. So how many digits did we have? We have 5 digits. So for 5 digit, we have a GP, a geometric progression, which is 2 raised to power 1 plus 2 raised to power 2. And let's say there were x digits in the lucky number. Okay, so we will have this thing up to 2 raised to power x minus 1. So this can be rewritten up as by using the formula, which is a r raised to power n, which is this, minus 1 over r minus 1, which is 2 minus 1. So on solving this, we can get is 2 raised to power, this is x, 2 raised to power x minus 2. Now 2 raised to power x can be written in computer as 1 left shift x. We have talked about this thing in earlier video, so you can go and check that out. Okay, so we can write it as 1 left shift x and minus 2 as it is. So this can be written in this form. Okay, so one part of the answer is this. One part of the answer is this and then minus 2. Okay. And the other part of the answer, so let's see our example, which was 74747. Okay, So let's start from here. This is 0 index 1, 2, 3 and 4. So on 0 index we have 7. So a number less than 7 can be 4. So for this position we have 2 raised to power 0, that is 1. One another number which is less than this, okay. And for 4 we cannot have anything less than this, because we can have either 4 or 7. So there is no possibility on this. For this we can have like 2 raised to power 2, which is 4, because we can have this combination. Let's take this thing. So it was 747. So we can have another number which is less than this as 744. We can have 474. We can have 477, and then we can have 4, 4 and 4. So these are the 4 numbers. So here we'll get a 2 raised to power 2, which is 4. Now this is 4, so we cannot have anything here. This is 7, so what we can have is 2 raised to power 4, that is 16. So this will sum up to 16, 4 and 1. So it will be 21. So this part of the answer is 21. And here we can see that when we will solve this, which is 2 raised to power 1 plus 2 raised to power 2 plus 2 raised to power 3, and then 2 raised to power 4, it will give us 30. So here we have 30 plus 21, so which is 51. So what this shows us is that there are 51 number which are less than this lucky number. So the index of this current lucky number will be 51 plus 1, which is equal to 52. Okay, I hope this thing is clear to you, and now I'll show you the code. I hope things will be more clear with that. Okay, so let's see the code. Okay, so we have the code right here. This code is in C++. So let me explain you this code line by line. So we created an array. Sorry. So we created an array, and that array is of character type, because in the question the constraint is 10 raised to power 9. So we can have a very large number which is a lucky number. Okay. So that's why we are taking it inside an array. So we input this thing inside an array of character, and then we calculate the number of digits here, that how many digits are there in the number. Okay, so this strlen function does this for us, and then we can have an answer. So initially we are initializing this answer as 0. Now the first part which I showed you was that geometric series, which was 2 raised to power 1 plus 2 raised to power 2 plus 2 raised to power 3 and so on up to 2 raised to power x minus 1. So this is what we have right here with us, which was converted into a formula, which was 1 left shift the number of digits we have, and then we can have a minus 2. Okay, this was the formula we constructed right now. So we are applying that formula right here for answer. Now we can have another loop. The loop is for this thing. Let's see the same example. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, or this is 4. So here we are writing it like this, but if you want to go to this place, what we can do is we can have something like digits, the number of digits we have minus 1. So number of digits here will be 5, digits here will be 5, and then minus 1 will be 4. Okay, so we will reach up to this index, because the last digit is a null character. In C++, any character array has last digit as null character. Okay, so we are doing a minus 1, and then we are accessing that place. So we'll access this place. And so after accessing, we are going to be checking if it is 7 or not. Because if it is 4, we cannot have any number less than this. Okay, so that will not be any case. So if we have 7, we can have a number less than that, that is 4. So here we have kept this I for the indexing. And here we have this count, which is checking the position. So if the number was this, this is 0th position, 1st, 2nd, 3rd and then 4th. Okay, so this is what we are doing here. Now if there is the, if the number is 7, then what we have to check is the position. So whatever the be the position, we will have 2 raised to power that position. Okay, and that 2 raised to power position we can write as 1 left shift the position, because that is equivalent to this thing. So we will add that thing with that. This is like answer plus answer equal to answer plus this thing, 1 left shift the count. The count is certainly here the position. Okay, so this is the position. So for every position we will keep on adding, like for this position we will add 2 raised to power 2, this position we will add nothing, this position we will add 2 raised to power 2, this position we will add nothing, and here we will add 2 raised to power 4. So after this, all these iterations of this for loop, we will get an answer which is 51, as I showed you. So there are 51 number less than that lucky number, and to get the index of the current lucky number, we can add 1 to it. So I hope this thing is quite clear to you. If there is some problem, you can comment and doubt. Okay, so let me run up this code. So let's put the same thing we did here, which was 7, 4, 7, 4, and 7. Okay, so it is giving us an answer of 52. Now let's put 74. Yeah, it is 5th because we have this sequence of 4, 7, 44, then 47, and then 74. So this is the 5th number. Okay, I hope this code is quite clear to you. I'll share this code in the description below, and if there is any doubt regarding this question, you can ask that in comment section. If you like the video, please like the video, click the like button and hit the subscribe button, please, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.